Hey, good morning, everybody.
This is Jamie with EverythingAirplanes.com. I'm at Pioneer Airport in Oshkosh on the grounds of Experimental Aircraft Museum.
We're taking a little break from airplanes today. We're at the Kennedy Space Center.
I'm at Thunder Over Michigan 2019, Southern Museum of Flight in Birmingham, Antique Airplane Club fly-in called the Grassroots Fly-in in Broadhead, Wisconsin.
This is Jamie with EverythingAirplanes.com. Doing a little bit of a different format today. Want to try and get to know you guys a little bit, let you know me a little bit. I want to try and get some information out about what I've planned for EverythingAirplanes.com. I've been in the aviation industry for about 40 years. I've got a lot of stories to tell. I've got a lot of contacts in the industry. And about 5 years ago, I was in Washington, D.C., and I decided to take a little bit of time in Arlington Cemetery to pay tribute to some of the aviation heroes that I had as a kid growing up. I was able to go and stand before the grave sites of Jimmy Doolittle, Pappy Boyington, Claire Chennault, Hap Arnold. A lot of these guys really influenced my growing up and my decision to go into aviation. I was also able to go and stand before one of my heroes when I was growing up, Gus Grissom, who passed away in the Apollo 1 fire. Standing before his site and being able to snap a salute and honor him was just amazing. But originally, that's what Everything Airplanes was dedicated to. And it's kind of blossomed from that. Instead of just bringing the Pioneer Aviators and the gravesite visitations that I've tried to do in the past, I like to cover everything that flies, and that includes everything from model airplanes to the space shuttle. I'm interested in it. Like I said, I've been in aviation for about 40 years. I plan to continue to go out to air shows and museum visits and report on the things that I see. I would like to serve you as an aviation consultant or aviation coordinator for my viewing audience, and I want to do this full time. I really want to get out there and do Everything Airplanes full time. Go out on the road, meet people, find different airplanes, and tell the stories of aviators, aircraft designers, restorers, whomever it is that has a good story to tell regarding aviation and their aviation experience. I want to be able to bring that to you. I get so excited when I go to museums or I go to air shows and I see a one of or the first one that's been restored or the last one that's flying. I really get excited about that. I have a passion for that. I've located a couple different airplanes. The Ryan Vertijet that you see on the picture right now is one example of just a few that were ever made, and this is the only one that's still around. There's another airplane. It's called the Lockheed Yo-3. This was a derivative of the Schweitzer glider that Lockheed put together for reconnaissance over Vietnam and the battlefields. I saw this airplane about a year ago, had no clue what it was, and for me to not know anything about an airplane is pretty unusual because I'm pretty up on my aviation history, but I finally went back to the museum and I asked the Dawkins what it was and got some information and able to get under the ropes with the guys and come to find out that there were only 11 of these made, and there's only four or five of them that are still in existence. So for me to see one of 11 that were ever made and one of the few that are still available to the public to see is just, that's like a treasure that I've found for me personally. Pioneer Aviators, there's a lot of people, a lot of Pioneer Aviators that I'd like to still honor. Harriet Quimby is one and she's buried out in the Westchester area of New York. She was actually the first woman pilot licensed in the United States. I've been to the Wright Brothers gravesites down in Dayton. I've also been to Glenn Curtis's gravesite in New York. I went out to California last year and visited the gravesite of the great engineer, Kelly Johnson. I can't explain it to you, but I think you understand my excitement when I pay honor to these men and women because they are the ones that have established the aviation community. I do have a comment section on my website. I would love to hear from you. I would love to see if there's airplanes or events that you would like to see that I could cover. But and I want to do this full time, and this is where partially this is why the this video is being made. I need some help. The last visit I made down to Alabama, my flight down there, the rental car, a couple of days in a hotel, cost me about $800. And I can afford to do that for a while, but I can't afford to do it forever. And I want to do this as a full-time job. Eventually, I'd like to have Everything Airplanes become a TV program, either on like Discovery Channel or the Smithsonian or somebody that might pick me up if I get enough support from my YouTube channel. And then you'd be getting this content on your local TV channel. I'm not doing it for the money. I have a passion for this. I want to get the information out. I want to honor the pioneer aviators that have paved the way for me. And I think there's a lot of stories out there that haven't been told. Right now I've got four pilots from Vietnam through Korea that want to tell me their stories. And I'm excited about that because I want to be able to tell their stories. And once these men and women are gone, we're going to lose that heritage. We're going to lose that history. And I want to be the guy that people call to say, listen, I've got a great uncle or I've got a grandpa that used to fly in World War II or in Korea, that he's 88 years old now, and we want to make sure that his stories are told for next generations. I'm really concerned about losing this history and losing this passion for aviation. I wanted to be like Gus Grissom. I wanted to be like Bob Hoover. I wanted to be like Scott Crossfield. I wanted to be a test pilot. I saw these guys as being almost superhuman with what they were doing, and a lot of times these guys would put their lives in jeopardy to accomplish another goal that we needed to get to the next step in our aviation and space conquest. And I want to follow the space program. It's being revitalized now, and that's part of what I want to do with the part of what I want to cover with Everything Airplanes. I've been doing this for 40 years. I got my first airplane ride in a 1941 Waco UPF biplane, and I've been in love with aviation ever since. I hope my passion comes across in the events that I've covered. I know last year when I was at Willow Run for the Thunder Over Michigan 2019, and they had the 11 Corsairs there. One of the best things that I've ever seen in my life. I don't know that I'll ever see 11 Corsairs in the same place at the same time. And you can tell by my backdrop that I am a huge Corsair fan, and I've chased them all over the planet for years, decades. It's that kind of excitement that I want to bring to aviation fans. I've been to several of the space museums. I've been to Hutchinson, Kansas on the Cosmosphere. I've been down to Huntsville with the U.S. Space and Rocket Center. Both are just unbelievable. I just got back from a trip down to Titusville with the Kennedy Space Center, and it was unbelievable. My son and I got to experience that together. The night after we went to Kennedy Space Center on their tour, we were actually able to witness our first Falcon launch at the Cape, and it was incredibly inspiring. It was just an unreal experience that I was able to do with my son. There is a donation button on www.everythingairplanes.com. I'm looking for opportunities or for suggestions as to how to get some government money or some sponsorship money that I can use on my feeds to sponsor different companies if you're willing to help me. I will be putting some of my larger content on Patreon at some point. And if you're really interested, I hope you'll support me. I look forward to that opportunity. Again, when you hear, hi everybody, this is Jamie with EverythingAirplanes.com, that's me. And I'm excited to bring these next years, decades to you in aviation. There's a lot going on, a lot of neat things that are being experimented with that I'd love to cover for you guys. And there's the old time stuff too. If you look at some of my videos, I really like the old biplanes and the golden age of airplanes and everything in between. I'm really on an X-plane kick right now. Have some contacts in some of the key places where there's X airplanes listed that I might be able to get into and see. So I'll bring that to you as soon as I get it. Just dozens and dozens of people that I've got listed. I went to see and found the gravesite of Clyde Cessna, which is way out in the middle of Kansas. That was an experience, and I still need to write about that. But it's like a treasure hunt for me when I go to find these airplanes or find these aviation pioneers that I can write on and give honor to. I look forward to hearing from you. I hope my content is appealing to you and that it's interesting and that you have the same passion for aviation that I do. I'm planning on going to film the Arsenal of Democracy flyover in Washington, D.C. on May 8th this year. I've got access to some of the planes and pilots already, I know. I'm planning on going to Oshkosh again this year. I don't know about Thunder over Michigan. I'll have to see what their lineup calls for. But I also plan on going out to the Reno Air Races, first time in 20 years that I've been out there. So lots of good content, lots of good stories that are coming your way. Again, I hope that you're passionate about it as I am. And I hope that I can do a good job of bringing you the aviation that you may or may not be able to see on your own. Again, www.everythingairplanes.com. Everythingairplanes.com on YouTube, and that's DOTCOM. I really, really would enjoy bringing this content to you as a full-time position. I want to get everybody involved with it as much as I can and cover the things that you're looking for, whether it be radio control airplanes or model airplanes or ultralights or gliders, whatever it is, warbirds, I will be covering it. And I hope you'll join me for the journey and support me in my quest to bring everything airplanes to you. I thank you for listening and look forward to your support. Hi guys, this is Jamie with Everything Airplanes, signing off.